How's it going, everybody? It's your boy Max here, and welcome everybody to vlog number 3 on my Vancouver winter trip. Although it doesn't feel like winter, to me this is like spring. We're rocking the Team Canada hat that I got yesterday. I'm not wearing gloves this time. I keep complaining about fucking gloves, and then I'm just not gonna wear gloves this time. Got out of breath there for a second. What I gotta do first off, and this is like no debate, is I gotta get some Advil. I got some problem with my hip, that it'll flare up every now and again, and it hurts to walk, and because I'm mainly walking, it makes life shittier than it has to be, you know, shittier than it has to be. So, I'm gonna go get some Advil. Hopefully there's like a Shoppers nearby or something like that. It's also raining, if you can't hear by the fucking loud ass splashing from the cars. It's not too bad right now. Like it's not pouring or anything. It's just like, again, just spitting, and it's just constantly there. The thing that sucks the most about that is my glasses. As you can kind of see, it just gets all over it, and I just can't fucking see. But that's fine. I appreciate you guys watching the first couple vlogs. I did a little bit better on the second vlog, not going out. It's like 1:30, 2 o'clock, right now. Hopefully meeting with a friend later today as well. Everyone here is walking with umbrellas. But like, what the fuck is this guy doing? Okay, shh, quiet, all right? Still better than minus 30 in snow. So if I get frustrated with the weather here, I just have to tell myself, you know what? It's better than freezing to the sidewalk back home.
One of the tallest escalators I've ever been on.
It's massive.
I don't know what the fuck. It's so tall. I didn't realize we were this deep underground. Made me get one. I got a caramel macchiato from Starbucks. So it's been a minute since I've had one. Why not?
So good. I know the song that's playing. Oh, never mind. I knew what song it was playing, but it was all distorted. I couldn't actually tell what it was. I mean, I hate myself for not knowing that now. If y'all could hear it in the background, let me know, because I know it. I can't remember the last time I wore a non-Boston Bruins hat out in public. Just a fun fact for you. Also, I don't know why I got a cold drink, because my hand is freezing at the moment. Why have I not done my vlogs in cinematic? This feels like a complete waste of, what the fuck? This many pigeons in one area. I don't know what they're eating. I can't see what they're trying to eat or what they're trying to get at. Also, this dude over here is playing banger tunes. I figured out who's playing the music. It's this guy. Just blasting tunes on that speaker over there.
I don't think you could see it. That speaker right there.
Just blasting bangers right now. It's, I don't know why. I thought it was like coming from some store or something, and I don't know what he's doing. Like, he's not dancing to the music or anything. He's just standing there. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what these pigeons are doing. Vancouver's wild, bro. The cinematic. Let me know if you guys prefer this one or the regular. I think this one looks dope, but I don't know if it could be like oversaturated. Like, I'm talking about pigeons fucking each other and like it's in cinematic mode. Like, I just feel like it's overused. But let me know what y'all think, because I'm kind of indifferent to it. Right now, I think this looks dope. But maybe on YouTube, it doesn't look as good. I don't know. It just blurs the background. That's all it really does. But I got the brand new iPhone 13 Pro, so I might as well use it to my full advantage, right? Right? I can't feel my hands. This hand. Because it is holding a cold beverage. You might be asking yourself, Max, why don't you just put on your glove? You know, you still have your one glove. And while I would say, yes, this is accurate, I would also switch the point and say, I'm like already long gone. To the point where it's like, is it even worth it? You know, is the glove even gonna do anything that's beneficial? What am I saying? I don't know what I'm rambling on about. I'm just trying to fill in the vlog because I haven't done anything all day. I don't know why any of you watch these goddamn things. And this caramel macchiato isn't even that good for the price I paid for it. And it's smaller than an average, I'm not even gonna continue speaking. I don't know. Let me know what y'all want me to do. But I can't see what y'all want me to do because I put my glove on, but
I saw a dollar store that's across the street, so I'm gonna cross the street right now, and I'm gonna hopefully get gloves there.
I lied to y'all. It's actually a Dollarama. It's not a dollar store.
There is a difference.
These unlocked a memory that I forgot I had. These are the off-brand ones. Obviously, they're not gonna have them at the Dollarama, but bro, the OG Teddy Bear Grahams,
like.
Also, these mint wagon wheels. A1. Should I get? Do I want them all listed? No. I couldn't find gloves that you can use. They have regular gloves, but I can't use my phone with them, so pretty much useless. So, not gonna get anything from Dollarama today. Unfortunately, I was expecting to, but it is what it is. And again, everybody just stares at me. Security guard followed me the entire time I was in the store. Which, I mean, rightfully so, I have a backpack on. But, this gets fucking annoying. I think I'm gonna go into CF Pacific Center, and we're gonna see. I doubt I'm gonna get anything in there. I just like walking around these stores. The biggest thing is, like, I'm not a huge fashion freak. I'm not somebody who, also, mind you, I don't go out a lot. Like, I don't go, says the guy who's literally vlogging him going out. But, like, I don't go out when I'm in Saskatoon and stuff like that. Like, so for me to get, like, really nice clothes and stuff like that, just seems kind of pointless, you know what I mean? I could go back into Hudson's Bay, if you guys remember from last time. It's, like, 105 floors, and it's, like, the biggest Hudson's Bay I've ever been to. But, you know, what's the point of that, right? So I don't know. I just like walking around these stores and stuff like that. And so I usually just wait for, like, when I go to malls and stuff, I usually just end up going to the sports store, which is where I got this hat. Because I just walk around malls and I'm like, oh, look at that. It's a sports thing. It used to be one of my favorite buildings. It's the Telus building, I think. Yeah, it's the Telus building. Gotta be one of my favorite buildings in the whole city. I can't zoom in, but just seeing how the cranes work and how they're like
side of the building is just fascinating how human beings can do this shit, bro. Like, I am a human being and I understand how all of it works. It's just blows my brain all the time. There's BC Place right ahead of me. That's where I'll be going tomorrow. Well, not BC Place, but I'll be going to Riders Arena. They're right beside each other. I'll show you
there. The big, like, art, like the big,
describe it, like sailboat anchor things. I don't know. It's basically, I think it's for the retractable roof, so like can lift it and open it and stuff. This is also a weird building
here. It just looks like a bunch of like bricks that you'd get as a kid when a kindergartner students, and they probably just walked in one day and was like, you know what, we love what you're doing, kid. And he was like 3 years old and designed that.
They designed a building for downtown Vancouver to look the same thing. It's kind of cool. Plans that were already lacking have somehow changed. I'm not going to hang out with a friend.
Watch a G-Wagon.
So sick. I'm not actually hanging out with a friend on today. She, like, 30 minutes. She got off work 30 minutes late, and she needs to do some other stuff tonight anyways. So we're going to reschedule for Thursday. So today, I'm going to go get food. I haven't eaten a morsel of food all day long somehow. I don't know how. Like, I'm not overly hungry, but now that I'm thinking about food, I'm like, you know what? Kind of hungry. So I'm going to go sit down and eat. Just got to find where. I saw the Keg. I know it's kind of expensive, but I haven't ate at the Keg in a long ass time. So I'm kind of tempted to go there. Maybe we'll go there.
I love this.
People said, you'll hate. What the fuck? Almost saw an accident. Literally turned around. Some dumbass was just doing a U-turn for no reason other than just that. Okay, also, it's a very nice vehicle. I assume it's all electric too. It's pretty dope. I don't know what I want to do to eat. Because the Keg is, it's too fancy for me. Especially in this attire. It's tough, man. It's tough out here.
81. Any extra large slice on Tuesdays? Lucky today's Tuesday. Let's go.
Well, it was like $2.50 because I decided to tip just because it's so cheap. But like, this is a, got tons of toppings. There was tons of different flavors. Like, it's not like your basic pepperoni and Hawaiian and stuff.
That is really good. The bottom is like perfectly crispy. She like put it in the oven to reheat it. I definitely want to come back to that. That's really good. That was very good. I'm happy I got this. I just stumbled upon it. Cheap pizza like that is the best. I love that. If any of you guys follow Nate, I forget his YouTube and his TikTok. If any of you follow him, he goes to like Europe, he goes to Poland, and he goes to all these different places living really cheaply. And I love his vlogs. I love his style of vlogs. I'll make sure to drop his channel down in the description. And I just really appreciate the style of his vlogs and stuff. And this is something that he would do. So quick shout out to him. He's got like 700,000 TikTok followers and like 15K on YouTube, but it's fine. Right there is like all glass. You can see some of the windows that are open right now. Oh, I was curious. It is the One Wall Center, and it was built in 2001, or it finished building in 2001, and it's for apartments. There are apartments up there. That's all for like $9.9 million. What? There's a few in there as well for like $1-2 million. It's insane. Obviously, like that's what I was expecting, but it just goes to show to live in like a giant glass tube above one of the biggest cities in Canada costs you about anywhere from $2 to $9 million, depending on obviously the ones that are like around the outside, and the higher you go, probably more expensive. But if you're curious and you want to see what like pictures and stuff looks like, I was looking online, and I mean, they look good. I don't know if I would pay $9 million, but I don't know. I'm not rich. And I did a little more research, and on the website that I found for the $9.9 million, if I were to put a down payment of $2 million, I would still be paying $34,000 a month on just the mortgage. That's not including the fucking taxes to live in that. Like, how do people have this money? Like, what are you doing? I want to know. I would love to talk to the people who live in those apartments. And to build a building like that, to know that there's going to be a market for people to buy those buildings, like to buy those apartments. Like, that's what's crazy to me, is that there's people like to build that building. They were confident enough that they were going to build that entire building. It's the fourth biggest building in the whole city. And they were like, you know what? People are going to buy these for millions of dollars. Okay. How y'all doing? I'm in like a residential more so area. It's very like, I was just about to say it's way quieter as a car drives by, but it's way nicer. Really, it's just like a residential area is basically, I don't know. There's more people walking on the streets. There's just, feels more like, I don't know, less hustle and bustle, more peaceful, I guess. I keep saying that. I swear there was no cars driving in the 10 minutes before I recorded this clip. And now there's tons. I don't know. Like, they watch my vlogs and they're like, oh, we gotta go distract Max now. It started to rain a little bit more. I'm very proud of myself, by the way. I was completely lost and I found my way without having to use Google Maps whatsoever. So high five for Max, let's go. If you're watching at this point of the vlog, comment down below, high fives for Max. And I'll know you'll watch up to this point, which is awesome. I love this this walkway. It's one of my favorites. It's on West Georgia. This is, I think Stanley Park is right over that way. And the exit to like Whistler and stuff is over that way as well. But I love walking this path here. And I don't know what I'm gonna do. I might just go to the bar, just hang out for a little bit. And we'll see what happens after that. If that'll be for the rest of my night, I'm not too sure quite yet, but I'm having a great time. And tomorrow is when the vlogs are gonna get a little more interesting for you guys. Obviously, I will have been at the game, and the Burns play tomorrow against the Vancouver Canucks. Game starts at 7 p.m. I'm going to, like I said, try to get there as soon as I possibly can so I could, you know, see warm-ups and stuff like that. And I'll try to get interactions with you guys and stuff, but it is what it is. Said we would come here when it's like, look at that. Bro, look at that. That is so cool. Saskatoon needs to, they need to put a big tree. I don't know where the fuck they would put it. But like, it doesn't need to be that big because Saskatoon is so flat, like everything would look massive. But like, that's pretty fucking dope. I'll show you the other way around. It's a big motherfucking tree. Looks real, it looks a lot better lit up. Yeah, that looks pretty cool. And nighttime in Vancouver is not that bad. Perhaps having an umbrella would be nice. It's really not, like, my hat's barely wet. I'm not getting wet, and this is like a rain jacket. It's more my feet, so the umbrella wouldn't really help because I'm like stepping in puddles and stuff. But other than that, I'm almost at the bar, so
that should be fun. There's the tree. I'll put it in like non-blur mode so you can actually see it. Maybe that'll be the thumbnail. Happy Christmas season.
Hello everybody, just got back. I only had 5 beers this time, so we're fucking fine. Also, the bartender I saw from the summer, Cass, she was my bartender today, and she actually remembered me at the end when I was paying. She's like, I swear I remember you from somewhere. And I was like, well, I was here in the summer. She's like, has it been that long? I'm like, yeah, you called me Bud Light. And she's like, I knew I remembered you. I'm like, that's a massive W for your boy, Max. Yeah, that's a huge W. And no, I didn't ask for her Insta or her Snap or anything. Like, it's just cool to know that people remembered me. I mean, I did spend like 2 full weeks hanging out there every single night. Don't even stress about it, all right? I don't know why I wanted to record that, but I wanted to record that. What did I just step on? I just stepped on bread. This wonderful BC place behind me. I don't know where I'm walking to. I just started walking. There's a pet hospital for some odd reason by BC Place. I don't know. BC Place is massive, by the way. Yeah, tomorrow I'm going to a BRUINS game. It also feels like it's like 11 o'clock at night, but it's only like 8 p.m. And I think that's pretty lit, I gotta say. And shout out to you guys. Like, in my mind right now, it's so weird because I don't feel drunk, but I can tell my body is acting as if it's drunk. But I'm not. Like, I just feel more confident and like I'm talking louder because these fucking cars are in my way. Like, what the fuck? I have zero idea where I am other than the fact that BC Place is following me. I am under some overpass where this tunnel has been louder than a fucking concert. I couldn't think of another fucking metaphor, but okay. I don't know where I am otherwise. This is Costco, actually. I'm not gonna cross the street because it says I'm unable to because it's a red hand, which means I'm not allowed to actually cross the crosswalk, but I'm going across the crosswalk. There we go. See, now I'm able to because there's the white man that is letting me know that it's safe to cross. But I gotta say, tonight has been fantastic. It's a little cool, I must say. But like, it's not freezing. Like, oddly enough, I'm warmer than I was earlier in the day when the sun was sort of out. I don't know how body temperature works. I'm not a scientist, knowledge temperature. Wandered to a spot I've never been in Vancouver before. I hear police sirens and ambulance sirens, and I don't know how to get back. I could use Google Maps, but you know, I'm a big bad boy. I know how to get home. We'll figure this out. I don't know what's happening. I'm very scared. The ambulance just kept driving away. I'm gonna cross the road. I don't know where I am. Make a decision to go get more alcohol at this restaurant right here. Should I? No. Will I? Yes. I also lost my other mask. I don't know where I went. Good thing I have extras. Never been this drunk in my life. I went to another bar and got another drink. For the first time, like, I'm actually wobbly, I'm actually dizzy, I'm actually, like, I feel drunk, but my brain knows that I'm drunk, but I am, like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not gone in my brain. Like, I know I'm drunk. I'm just gone. But regardless, I think I'm going to start heading back. Still kind of a little bit hungry. I didn't eat anything at the last bar. There was nothing that like really came out to me that I wanted. I do still have chips at home that I never eat yet, so I might go eat that. But we'll see. If on the ride home I see something that I might want, well, you know, that could be game over. But regardless, let me know if you guys think I look drunk. Because, like, again, I like in my head it's here. I know I am drunk. I know I like I'm obviously intoxicated, but like I also don't necessarily feel it because I am. But like I walk slower, my perception of space is different. I don't know. I'd also like to know where my other mask went, but whatever. I'll see y'all whenever. The final walk to the Airbnb. I am so tired. I also really gotta pee. Yeah, I'm exhausted. I was slept on like both trains. Like I kept dozing off on both sky trains, but I'm really tempted to get a cheeseburger from McDonald's, but I know I have chips at home. I don't have anything to drink though, which might come back to haunt me. Fuck it, I'll stop at the gas station really quick. Maybe they even have a washroom in there, I don't know. But I'll get something to drink because I know I'm probably going to regret it either tonight or tomorrow. Not having anything to drink right away. But yeah, I don't know. I hope y'all are okay when I film and stuff. You know, even if I'm a little intoxicated. But I'm not like overly offensive or anything like that. And if I was, I probably would take the clips. And I wouldn't upload them or anything to TikTok and YouTube or anything like that. Like I wouldn't upload it if it was offensive or anything. I just think it's funny. Whatever. Especially because I don't ever get drunk in my life, ever. Like this is the most drunk I've ever been in my life. And for a lot of people, the most drunk that they've ever been in their life is like they're passed out on the fucking couch, blacked out. They don't remember a single fucking thing of what happened. Me, I'm still walking through downtown Toronto. Toronto? I don't know where I am, apparently. Downtown Vancouver. I'm able to locate myself and, I don't know. It is what it is. But, I'll probably see you guys when I am, I'll show you guys what I get to drink. Because I'm walking over to Chevron again tonight. And, I'm really tempted to get a cheeseburger from fucking Don's. I won't, though. I won't. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow after the game or something. But yeah, so yeah, tomorrow will be a better vlog. Tomorrow will probably be the best vlog. So make sure you guys tune into that. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And yeah, I'll see you guys when I'm at Chevron. Mine. I guess never mind. Fucking, it says it's open 24 hours every single day of the week. And I can't physically open the door. Either I'm weak as fuck or I just can't open. I don't know. The owner or the guy working there is literally sitting at the desk, head down. But fuck me, I guess. Whatever.
All right, y'all. I'm home safe. It's like 11:30. I'm very tired, but I'm probably just going to watch YouTube until I fall asleep and pass out. Make sure my phone's charging and stuff. And then, yeah, tomorrow's vlog will be good. Going to BRUINS game. Pretty hyped. I feel very dizzy. But hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe. Peace out.